Hello and welcome to Arzel Zoning, where today we're going to show you how to diagnose our solenoids. In a previous video, we went over testing the pump, so we know the pump in this panel is good. Now we need to take a look and see if we have an issue with the solenoids. When you're testing the solenoid, you're going to need a digital voltmeter, you're going to need a digital manometer, and a pair of needle nose pliers. You might need a little screwdriver. What we recommend first when you're going to test the solenoids and pumps is you jump route all your fan calls, or you go to your thermostats and you turn the fan switch to on, turn the heating cooling switch to off. With the fan running, all of my zone solenoids are going to be on vacuum. And then all we have to do is disconnect the G-call here, and that'll open and close the solenoids so that we can test those. So with my fan calls all jumpered out on each of my zones, we're gonna turn the panel on. Our pump is started. We got a fan call on each of our zones. The first thing we're going to do is we're going to check to make sure that our solenoid connections are working correctly. So we're going to set our meter to DC voltage. And then with our meter set to DC voltage, we're going to check between the plus terminal. On the AirBoss, we have two plus terminals. On the Heat Pump Pro and the MPS, we're going to have a single plus terminal. But locate your plus terminal. You're going to check from plus to 1, plus to 2, plus to 3. Each of those is showing 0 volts DC, and then to verify that our meter is working, we're going to check to the unused zone, and that shows 24 volts DC. So we know our meter is working, we know that our zone solenoid connections are working, and then we can proceed to check our vacuum and our pressure. So first thing we're going to do is we're going to check our vacuum. We're going to pull, if you didn't save the red caps, you'll have to use a short piece of tubing with a plug. But you want to isolate all your dampers from your panel. So put your red caps back on your solenoids and connect your manometer directly to one of the solenoids. With our manometer connected to the solenoid, I'm only seeing 0.96 inches of water column. Now normally we're going to be seeing what we had at our pump, and in the previous test we did with the pump, we were around 60 inches. But since we're not getting 60 inches, we know we've got something causing that pressure drop. Now we can check the other solenoids, moving our manometer around just to see if any of those are reading differently. But as we move our manometer around, we need to make sure that we cap off the unused port. So that's reading the same thing, 0.9. We'll go ahead and check our last zone. That's reading about 2.76 inches, so that's still very, very low. The last thing we're going to do is we're going to check our ModuPass port if we have it, because the ModuPass port is a constant pressure port, and since all of our solenoids are supposed to be vacuum, we should be reading something different on a port that's supposed to be pressure. So on our ModuPass port, we're only getting 5 inches. When we tested the pump, we were up around 60 inches. So that tells us that something in here is leaking. Now to figure out if it's a solenoid, we know that each of our solenoids are supposed to be under vacuum. That's going to be this black and blue stripe line running across the top. Our pressure line is going to be the black and yellow stripe. So since they're all supposed to be under vacuum, we're going to pinch the black and yellow stripe line inside the panel and see if our manometer pressure changes at all. One at a time, we'll pinch each of our solenoids. No change in pressure with zone 1, no change in pressure with zone 2, or I mean with zone 3, so we'll pinch off zone 2, and then we see that our pressure instantly shoots up. We're getting 63 inches, so we found that our zone 2 solenoid is leaking. That's how you diagnose the Arzel solenoids. Pretty simple process. You just need a manometer, a digital voltmeter, and a pair of pliers.